Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with unit number 4 of EEE subject. The name of this unit is Introduction to Microcontroller. Myself, Professor Amit Mishra. I am Assistant Professor in Sandeep Institute of Engineering and Management, Sandeep Foundation, Nasik. So let's start with this unit. Very first topic in this unit is microprocessor. So first of all, what is a microprocessor? So microprocessor is a central processing unit of a general purpose digital computer. They can address megabytes of memory and operate on 8, 16, 32 bit data. It consists of, as you can see over here, it consists of ALU, accumulator, working registers, program counter, stack pointer, clock and interrupt circuit. You can see the architecture of microprocessor over here. Let's see the each block in detail. First is arithmetic and logic unit. This block is responsible for performing various arithmetic and logical operations. Now, what is this arithmetic? So arithmetic means addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. And what are logical units? So logical operations means AND, OR, NAND, NOR, etc. After that, stack pointer and counter. Now, these stack pointer and program counter is a memory element. It used to store the information or data. Stack pointer means the memory will be in form of stack, or we can say it is in the form of ladder. Now, what is program counter? So program counter, it going to hold the address of memory location of next instruction that microcontroller is going to execute. After that, accumulator and working register. These are again used to store the data. This consists of accumulator or working registers. It consists of different registers. Suppose we are writing a command move a comma hash 02h. That means 02 is going to store in a register A. In the same way, there are different registers in microprocessor which is used to store the data. Timing and clock circuit. Basically, this circuit, this block is responsible for counting the number of time a particular instruction has been executed or particular task has been performed. An interrupt circuit, which is the last part of this microprocessor architecture. Basically, this circuit, interrupt circuit, is responsible to check whether any interrupt has been occurred while execution of any program. For example, a microprocessor is executing a program and in between that some interrupt occurred due to input-output peripherals. So in that case, it is going to check the preference of that interrupt, whether the task which microprocessor is performing, that processor is performing, is of high priority than the interrupt. So the processor will continue with the execution of the program. Else, it will give the preference to that interrupt and stop the program for a while. Next is microcontroller. In microcontroller, all these units are on the same board. You can see the different units which was there in microprocessor, same units are there in microcontroller also. But in microcontroller, there are some more units which were not there in microprocessor. For example, you can see over here, serial input output port is there, then timer and counter is there. So the function of ALU, arithmetic logic unit, register, accumulator, timing and clock circuit, these are going to remain same. It extra consists of serial input output ports. Now we will see the comparison between microprocessor and microcontroller. Microprocessor is a chip that is dependent on other chips for many functions. Microcontroller is a single chip microcomputer that has everything inbuilt. A microprocessor contains ALU, general purpose registers, stack pointer, program counter, timing and control circuit with interrupt circuit. A microcontroller contains the circuitry of a microprocessor and has built-in RAM, ROM, input-output devices, timers and counters. Microprocessors have large memory address space and more data. Microcontroller have relatively small address space and less data. Microprocessor-based system require more hardware, whereas microcontroller-based system requires less hardware, reducing the PCB size and increasing the reliability. In microprocessor, access time for memory and input-output device are more, whereas in microcontroller, less access time for built-in memory and input-output devices. In microprocessor, clock rate are very fast. In microcontroller, clock rate is slow. Microprocessor are expensive, microcontroller are cheap. The next part, which is important, is the criteria for selecting a microcontroller. So, primary criteria for selecting a microcontroller are data size, clock speed, memory size, power consumption, cost per unit. So data size means microcontroller comes in various data size like 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit, etc. Clock speed as per the needed speed to complete operations in specified time. Memory size, as per the required size of program and estimate of space needed for live data. Power consumption, which is the fourth primary criteria, as per the availability of power and type of power available. It is critical for products that are battery operated. And the last criteria is cost per unit. So the final cost of product in which a microcontroller is used, that is, some microcontroller cost 50 cents per unit when 1 lakh units are purchased at a time. So these five are the primary criteria. Second is how easy it is to develop products around it. So based on that, there are three criteria for selecting a microcontroller. The first one is availability, second one is upgradability, and third one is maintainability. Now what is availability? Availability of microcontroller and other system components, current and over a period of time. Next is upgradability. So upgradability of microcontroller and other system components is incremental cost and value addition. Maintainability of microcontroller and other system components, on-site and component level repairs. The last criteria for selecting a microcontroller is ready availability. So the third criteria is ready availability in required quantity presently and in future. Means a microcontroller is available for is there, but it is not available when we will when there is a requirement for that. So there is no use for such microcontroller. So among all microcontroller, 8051 is easily available. It is originated by Intel and available easily in the market. Applications of microcontroller. So in home, it is used in telephones, security systems, TVs, remote control, paging, toys, fax machines, cellular phone. In office, telephones, laser printers, security system, paging, color printers. Automation field, it is used in airbags, ABS, entertainment, cellular phone. And other applications are square wave generation, pulse width modulation, sine wave generation, and frequency counter. There are other industrial applications also, like the microcontrollers are used in sensing the robot arm position, control speed and direction of DC motor, stepper motor control. Now, how a microcontroller can be designed? So there are two architecture for that. One is Hardward architecture, another one is Von Neumann architecture. Now what is Hardward architecture? So in Hardward architecture, there is program memory and data memory are separate. So now, first of all, what is this program memory? So program memory means which is going to store the instructions, and what is data memory, which is going to store the data. So their buses are different, wires are different for instructions in a program memory and for data memory. Therefore, at a time we can call the program, we can call the instruction, as well as we can call the data also. Therefore, this hardware architecture provide is basically it. If the microcontroller is designed through this, then that microcontroller will be a bit faster. In von Neumann architecture, there is a single memory, and the program memory and data memory will be same. So at a time, either we can call, we can execute instructions, or we can execute data. Parallel operation is not possible in von Neumann architecture. So von Neumann architecture, if microcontroller has been designed through this, it will be a bit slower. We will go a little bit detail for hardware and von Neumann architecture. For hardware, for this side it's hardware architecture, and this side it's von Neumann. So hardware, data and address bus is not separate. In von Neumann, data and address bus are separate. Microcontroller with von Neumann architecture are called SIS microcontroller, that is complex instruction set computer, and microcontroller with von Neumann architecture are called as RISC microcontroller, that is reduced instruction set computer. What is SISC and what is RISC? So RISC means, it stands for reduced instruction set computer, that means the instruction sets are limited, whereas in complex instruction set computer the programming is quite complex. Therefore hardware, there are more functions are available, and hence we can use those functions, and programming could be difficult, programming could be complex. Whereas in von Neumann, it depends on RISC, that means reduced instruction set computer. So the programming will be, the functions are limited, so programming will be a bit easier and not lengthier. Now hardware, again third point about hardware is time division multiplexing is used for fetching the program and data. And in von Neumann, the address and data buses are separate. Hence, there is no need to have the time division multiplexing. Hardware, it needs multiple fetches for processing an instruction, whereas there is no need of multiple fetches for executing an instruction. Example of a microcontroller which uses hardware architecture for its design, and those are MC68HC11. And example of microcontroller which are designed by hardware. Sorry, I'll just change the last one. The von Neumann architecture example is MC68HC11, an example of hardware is AVR, Atmega 16, Atmega 32, Atmega 328P. The next one is characteristics of RISC. RISC is, that is reduced instruction set computer. So the various characteristics of RISCs are, first is one instruction per clock cycle, second is reduced number of instructions, third is instruction pipelining, and fourth is register to register operations. We will see these characteristics. So the first characteristic of RISC is one instruction per clock cycle. Basically in RISC processors, there is one instruction per clock cycle. A machine cycle is defined as time required for fetching the operands, decoding and executing the instructions, and storing the result in register. So one instruction will be executed in one clock cycle, hence they can be executed very fast. Second is reduced number of instructions. It provides a limited instruction set that simplifies the design of control unit. Third is instruction pipelining. Instruction pipelining means in RISC architecture, there are several independent in CPU there are several independent units which operate in parallel. So one unit fetches the instruction, till then other unit decode and execute the instructions. So at an instant, many instructions are in different processing stages. All the RISC processors support pipelining. The last one is register to register operation. So it is important characteristic of RISC processor that encourages the optimization of register use. The operands that are frequently used are stored in high speed storage to perform the register to register operations. The RISC processor have multiple sets of registers. An example of a RISC microcontroller is AVR microcontroller. Before going on AVR microcontroller, first of all, we will see the history of 8-bit microcontroller. So in that, you can see over here the first point. In 1974, Texas Instruments introduced the first microcontroller with the name TMS-1000. Second is, in 1976, Intel introduced the first microcontroller, Intel 8048. When internal bus of microcontroller is 8-bit, the ALU can perform arithmetic and logic operations on a byte at an instruction. Such a microcontroller is called as 8-bit microcontroller. Why 8-bit microcontrollers are preferred over 16-bit microcontroller? Most of the designers are familiar with 8-bit microcontrollers. 16-bit operations can be done on 8-bit microcontroller by programming them. Word size is useful for computing small tasks. The ASCII data is stored in 8-bit format only. Also, interfacing 8-bit with memory IC is easy. Hence, we prefer 8-bit microcontroller over 16-bit microcontroller. Next is role of embedded systems. So, an embedded processor is an electronic device or electromechanical that incorporates microprocessor / microcontroller within its implementation. Means what? It's a combination of embedded means it's a combination of hardware and software for doing a particular job. Function. The main task of microcontroller and microprocessor is to simplify the system design and provide flexibility. Example of various embedded systems are intercom, cable TV tuner, camera, printers, telephone, fax machine, cell phone, video games, remote controls. The requirement of an embedded system is to reduce the power consumption and space. Next is open source embedded platform. What is open source? Open source means, first of all, I just told you, like, embedded means it's a combination of hardware and software. So any application where hardware is there, but to run that hardware, to perform any task on hardware, software is required. That will be called as embedded. Therefore, we require the software in embedded, and that software is freely available on internet. Then that will be called as open source. Arduino is an open source embedded platform. It is based on open source hardware and software, which is shared amongst the different users to encourage new development in the Arduino platform. Arduino was developed by David Massimo Benzi and Martino and David Mellis in Elvira, Italy. The main aim behind developing Arduino was to develop a microcontroller, hardware plus software, that can be easily used by different users / programmers. Atmega 328P is microcontroller commonly used in Arduino board. List of different Arduino processing boards that use Atmega 328. These are the different Arduino boards like Dumi, Lenovo, Arduino Uno, Arduino Ethernet, Arduino BT, Arduino Pro Mini 3285V, Arduino Nano 3.0, Arduino Mini, Arduino Pro 3.3V, likewise. And these all Arduino board belongs to Atmega 328P. These are the different parameters, we can say, of each. For example, Arduino Uno. So it has the SRAM of 2 kilobyte, flash memory of 32 kilobyte, and EEPROM of 1 kilobyte. SRAM is volatile memory. In flash, we use only one transistor to design. EEPROM is non-volatile. Likewise, for different Arduino board, you can get different memory as well as clock and other things from this chart or this table. We will see about these different Arduino boards. So the first one is Arduino Duo Lenovo. So this board consists of 6 analog input, 14 digital input output, 16 megahertz clock speed, 6 PWM, 32 kilobyte flash memory, 2 kilobyte SRAM, 1 kilobyte EEPROM, and it operates on 5 volt VCC. Next is Arduino Uno. In our practical, mostly we go with either Arduino Uno or Arduino Mega. So this Arduino Uno, it supports the latest design and a lot of shields to expand the functionality of the board. Let's see the different configuration of this board. So the board consists of 6 analog input, 14 digital input output, 6 PWM, 32 kilobyte flash memory, 2 kilobyte SRAM, 1 kilobyte EEPROM. Dimension of this board is 68.6 mm into 53.3 mm. Third is Arduino Nano. So functionality of Arduino Nano is same as that of the Arduino Duo Lenovo and Arduino Uno. However, its package is different than both. It employs a mini USB cable instead of standard USB cable used in Arduino Duo Lenovo and Arduino Uno. Arduino Nano consists of 8 analog inputs, 14 digital outputs, of which 6 are PWM outputs. Its clock speed is 16 MHz. It has SRAM of 2 kilobyte, flash memory of 32 kilobyte, and EEPROM of 1 kilobyte. Now we are going to start with AVR family. AVR is another category of microcontroller. This is the block diagram of AVR microcontroller family. We will see AVR in detail. I'll just read each line and will explain wherever it is required. So AVR microcontroller family member has same architecture. The difference is in the number of pins and packaging mode. These are the two students of NTH who develop AVR microcontroller architecture. It is an 8-bit RISC microcontroller with hardware architecture. It has data RAM, on-chip program ROM, data E2 PROM timers, input-output port, ADC, PWM, CAN, USB. You can see over here. AVR family architecture block diagram. Most of the program is stored in ROM. ROM size is of 1 kilobyte to 256 kilobyte depending on AVR family member. So they use on-chip flash memory for storing programs. It can be erased quickly. RAM is used for storing the data. RAM space in AVR family members varies from 1 kilobyte to 64 kilobyte. RAM has 3 space for 32 general purpose registers, SRAM and input output memory. AVR microcontroller can have 3 to 86 pins for input output depending on AVR family member. Atmega has 32 input output pins, and Atmega 1280 can use up to 86 pins for input output. AVR family can be classified as classic, mega, tiny, and special purpose. Mega AVR are very powerful microcontrollers. They have many new features and peripheral capabilities. What is peripheral capability? Interfacing with different devices it allows. Now Atmega family members. So 8051 peak, Atmega 32, Atmega 328. The parameters for Atmega, we are going to just compare these all four. So the parameters are number of pins, input output pins, program ROM, data RAM, square PROM, timers, speed and ADC. Number of pins in 8051 microcontroller are 40, in peak 40, Atmega 32 it's 40, and in Atmega 328 which we use in Arduino it's 28. Input output pins in 8051 32, in peak 35, Atmega 32 it's 32, and 23 in Atmega 328. ROM 4 kilobyte, peak 32 kilobyte, Atmega 32 kilobyte, Atmega 328 32 kilobyte. Data RAM 256 bytes, 2 kilobyte, 2 kilobyte, 2 kilobyte. E square PROM 0, 256 bytes, 1 kilobyte, 1 kilobyte. Timers 3 in 8051, 4 in peak, 3 in Atmega 32, and 3 in Atmega 328P. Speed in 8051 slow, in peak it's moderate, in Atmega 32 it's fast, and in Atmega 328P it's fast. ADC in 8051 it is not there, the analog to digital conversion, it's not there, analog to digital conversion, it's not there in 8051. In peak 10 bits are there, Atmega 10 bits, and Atmega 328 again it's 10 bit, means Atmega 32 and Atmega 328 the ADC is same. Atmega family members have more than 120 instructions. USART for serial data transfer. Special purpose AVR have special capabilities. They are designed for particular applications, that is ZigBee and FPGA. Just we have seen this comparison between 8051 peak Atmega microcontroller. Now we are going to start with the features of Atmega 328. Let's see the features of Atmega 328. It is high performance Pico power 8-bit microcontroller. It supports advanced RISC architecture with 131 powerful instructions. All the instructions need one clock cycle for their execution. It supports 2 kilobytes internal SRAM. It supports 1024 bytes E square PROM. It supports 10 bit ADC. It has 23 programmable input output lines for 3 input output ports B, C and D. Its operating range is 1.8 to 5.5 volt. It operates at a temperature range of minus 40 degrees Celsius to plus 85 degrees Celsius. To get more detail about how these 23 programmable input output pin lines are there, then what are those B, C, D ports, 3 input output ports and 10 bit ADC, I appeal all you to refer my videos on unit 5th. There I have explained the internal architecture of internal pin diagram of Atmega 328. In next video, I'll be sharing with you the basic introduction about Arduino IDE. Thank you.